Well, the highly sought after FISA warrant for Carter Page is now released to the public after many Freedom of Information Act requests and several lawsuits from government watchdogs. One America's John Hines caught up with the chief investigator for Judicial Watch for his take on the DOJ documents. Here's part one of that interview.
Yes, I'm here with Chris Farrell, who is director of investigations at the government watchdog group Judicial Watch. And Chris, I wanted to ask you a little bit about what's been going on. And this is, unless I'm mistaken, a significant victory for Judicial Watch. Talk about what happened.
Sure. Well, not just Judicial Watch, but frankly, it's a victory for the American people because they get to see what happens when federal law enforcement at the Department of Justice and the FBI abuse what's really a secret process, the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Court, and submit a pretty thin warrant application that appears to be really an abusive process where they've taken very loose, very dangerous material, presented it as though it was fact, it was real, when it wasn't. It was simply a political opposition research document, and they try to use that as a leverage to target a political campaign. This is pretty subversive stuff.
This is, of course, the FISA application for the Carter Page surveillance, which
right.
is what you had filed suit regarding this.
Correct.
So this is in response to your lawsuit.
Right. The documents that were produced, the warrant application, the production of that record was compelled by our lawsuit in the federal court, and the court ordered them to produce it to us.
And this is the first time in the history of, since the FISA court has existed, that they have done this.
That is correct.
Talk about the significance of that.
So it is very significant. You know, there's been thousands of foreign intelligence surveillance applications or warrants that have been acted on to conduct legitimate and surveillance of hostile foreign intelligence agents. But in this case, we have this targeting of Carter Page, who was a self-appointed volunteer advisor. He held no position with the campaign.
This is the Trump campaign.
Correct. He did not have a desk or an office or a phone or a building pass or a business card. This is just a guy who said, hey, I want to advise the campaign. Never met with the president, never met with any of his inner circle. But they used his self-proclaimed advisory status as a means to say, aha, he's connected to Trump. And this is a guy who's done business in Russia before. He worked for an investment firm. And so the element, the nugget of truth is grossly embroidered to the point where it's almost unrecognizable.